So Simple Tutorial.
Good morning students, welcome to SST So Simple Tutorial. My dear students, I hope your studies are going on well. In the previous class, we read two stories, one from Nepal and the other from Bolivia. Today, we will proceed further. First, we will discuss what conclusions we can draw from these examples of Nepal and Bolivia. Then, we will discuss mobilizations and organizations. So, let us begin. Look at page number 60 of your textbook. Second column. Can you see three green bullets there? I am going to discuss these points now. Okay. Conclusion number one. Democracy evolves through popular struggles. I suppose you know the meaning of evolution. To evolve means to develop gradually, slowly. For example, we say that humans evolved from apes. Similarly, democracy also evolves. It develops gradually. It evolves through struggles. Almost all democracies that we have seen have evolved through struggles. The United States adopted a democratic constitution in 1787. Did it give voting rights to everyone from day one? No. The voting rights was limited to few men only. People had to struggle for equality, freedom, and justice. In Nepal, people had to struggle before 1990 to establish democracy first, and thereafter in 2000 to restore democracy. So politically, what we say, Nepal was going through transition to democracy. It was moving from a non-democratic type of government towards a democratic government. Such a changeover is seldom smooth. It cannot take place without popular struggle. It is bound to involve struggle. In the previous chapter, we read about feminist movement, didn't we? What did we read there? We read that women had to struggle for equality, for equal rights. There is less involvement of women in political arena. This is the problem of expansion of democracy. Women are fighting this problem out. I hope you understand this point. Now look at the book, the last sentence of this point. Defining moments come when the country is going through the transition to democracy, expansion of democracy, or deepening of democracy. To understand these terms, transition to democracy, expansion of democracy, and deepening of democracy, please watch the first video of the last lesson, Challenges to Democracy. The link of the video is given in the description below. You can also watch the video by clicking on the I above. Okay. Conclusion number 2. Democratic conflict is resolved through mass mobilization. What is the meaning of mobilization? It means to organize or prepare something, such as the group of people for a purpose. When this mobilization takes place in mass, in very large number, it is mass mobilization. So what happens here is that group of citizens are mobilized for political actions like mass meeting, like strikes, demonstrations, processions, or even rebellion. Sometimes the ruling class also tries to mobilize the people to strengthen the authority of the government. Just recall, Nazi government used this technique of mass mobilization very effectively to win support for their policies. The Nazi party mobilized the population with mass meetings, parades, and other gatherings. I hope you understood mass mobilization. So normally, what happens is that if a conflict arises with the government, the conflict is resolved by the existing democratic institutions itself. Like, people go to the court for the resolution of a conflict. You just recall the Indira Sahni case that you read in class 9. People were not at all happy with the implementation of the Mandal Commission report. There were widespread protests. Who resolved the dispute? the solution finally came from the Supreme Court, isn't it? Sometimes the parliament also gives the solution. But if these institutions themselves get involved in the dispute, then the resolution has to come from outside these institutions, from the people sitting on the roads or sitting on some maidan. Okay, let us come to conclusion number 3. These conflicts and mobilizations are based on political organizations. In most of the historical moments, you will find spontaneity. Here you must understand the term spontaneous first. When something happens as a result of sudden impulse, without a premeditation, that means you did not plan it before, then it is spontaneous. Just as the people of Paris on 14 July, when they heard the rumor that the army is coming and will open fire upon them, they just stormed at the Bastille and demolished it. This was a spontaneous action. This was not planned. It just happened as an instant reaction. So what we observe in such examples of such struggles is that even if the participation is spontaneous, it becomes effective with the support of organized politics, and such type of support comes from political parties, pressure groups and movement groups. So let us revise the conclusions once again. 1. Democracy evolves through popular struggles. 2. Democratic conflict is resolved through mass mobilization. And 3. These conflicts and mobilizations are based on political organizations. Let us now switch over to the next topic, mobilization and organization. You can open page number 61 of your textbook. In the two examples that we read, do you think that these struggles would have succeeded without the help of, say, without the support of some organizations? Let us recall those organizations in Nepal. In the beginning, the call for indefinite strike was given by the SPA. Okay. Then the protest was joined by the Nepali Communist Party. Strange enough, the party which did not believe in the parliamentary democracy. This party was involved in an armed struggle against the Nepali government and had established its control over large parts of Nepal, mostly the rural areas. Other than political parties who joined the movement, you will find all the major labor unions and their federations. Some other organizations, like the Organization of the Indigenous People, lawyers, teachers, human rights groups, gave their support to the movement. In the case of Bolivia, you will see that the water war was not led by any one political party. Rather, it was led by an organization called FEDECO. This organization comprised local professionals, including engineers and environmentalists. They were supported by a federation of farmers, the Confederations of Factory Workers Union, middle-class students from the University of Cochabamba, and the city's growing population of homeless street children. So students, in a democracy, behind any big struggle, you will find not one, but different kinds of organizations working. They play their role in two different ways. One is direct and the other is indirect. What is the meaning of direct way? Direct way means direct participation in competitive politics. How is this done? This is done by forming parties, contesting elections and forming governments. That means you form your political party, you contest elections, win the election, form your government and implement your policy. But this is not possible for every citizen to do. For most of the people, participation means going to the polling booth and casting their vote. That's all. What are the indirect ways then? The indirect way by which people can get the government to listen to their demands is by forming interest groups, also called pressure groups, to promote their interest or viewpoint. You will read about them in the next video in details. That is all about the today's lesson, students. Students, you should be able to answer these questions now. 1. List the organizations involved in Nepal's movement. 2. What do you mean by FEDECO? 3. What is the direct way of influencing decisions in a democracy? 4. Mention indirect ways by which people can get government to listen to their demands. 5. Democracy evolves through popular struggles. Justify the statement. Dear students, let me stop here now. In the meantime, you read your textbook. In the next class, we will discuss the next part. What are pressure groups and what is a movement? Till then, keep reading and have a nice time. Thank you.